There's no other animal on this planet that is designed and as effective to do what vultures do in terms of cleaning up carcasses.
Vultures are facing mostly man-made threats.
Poisoning.
Power line collisions.
Human-wildlife conflict.
Electrocution.
Belief use in vulture body parts.
In the world of birds, there's nothing quite like the vulture. There are 9 species of them in South Africa, many of which are endangered. We'll get to that in a moment. But in the meantime, just have a look at these vultures. They are perfectly adapted to their role in the environment, which is cleaning up. And without them, our game reserves and our landscapes would be full of dying and decaying carcasses, and disease rates would be much higher as well.
Partyvoëls en roofvoëls is van hulle klauwe en snavels afhankelijk om een maaltijd te verseker. Maar wanneer dit bij aasvoëls komt, is uitstaande sig die vermoe om die hoogste hoogtes te bereik en al snavels wat hulle in al eie klas plaas. Aasvoëls het baie sterk snavels en verskillende aasvoëlspesies het ook elk unieke aanpassings. Swart aasvoëls is die sterkste van hulle soort. Hulle snavels kan karkasse oopskeer. Kraans en witrug aasvoëls se snavels is groot, dik en sterk, wat maak dat hulle deur spierweefsel en organe kan skeer. Monnik aasvoëls het kleiner, langer en dunner snavels waarmee hulle klein stukkies kos kan bykom. Aasvoëls lyk nou dalk nie na die mooiste voëls nie, maar hulle kwyt hulle self uiters goed van hulle taak. Kerry Walter is sedert 2007 aan die stuur van Walpro, een aasvoëlbewaarsentrum in Magaliesburg. Dis 'n toevlugsoord vir voëls wat nooit weer sal kan vlieg nie, en hulle fokus onder andere op aasvoëlrehabilitasie, die broei van aasvoëls, opvoeding en navorsing.
We do extensive field work, surveys, monitoring, basically anything and everything to do with trying to protect and understand the species and in order to maximize what we do to conserve them.
You talk about birds that need rehabilitation. What's happening to them that they're arriving with you?
What we deal with majority of the time are power line collisions and electrocutions. Electrocutions, most times the birds don't survive. Power lines, they survive, but result in broken wings mostly. Sometimes the bone is shattered, pierces straight through the bird's skin, and then we've got to amputate it, which is what you can see here. And if you look at this enclosure, all of these birds have are amputees. There's also other birds that we have that have various breaks, but not as severe as this, but they will never fly again. You know, we're getting about 70-odd vultures in every year, and we're only able to release 60% of those. So every year, the numbers do increase.
Andre Botha bestuur die Trust vir Bedreigde Species se Vultures for Africa program. Hy is ook medevoorsitter van die IUCN se aasvoëlbewaringsgroep en doen grootskaalse veldwerk regdeur Afrika en die wêreld.
I was part of and I led a process in 2016-17 to draft this plan, and this is just a summary of it. It's 10 pages, which is the multi-species action plan for African Eurasian vultures. And that was drafted with input from vulture specialists, conservationists, biologists from across 3 continents, Africa, Europe and Asia, providing input and doing an assessment of what the threats are that affects vultures, not just in Africa, but also on the other 2 continents. And the top 5 threats are all poisoning related.
Aasvoëlbewaarders is baie bekommerd oor vergiftiging wat met stropery gepaard gaan. Dit is 'n olifantkarkas wat vir ivoor gestroop is, en dit is die aasvoëls wat in die slag gebly het nadat hulle die karkas gevreet het, wat deur die stroopers met gif deurtrek is. Sirkelende aasvoëls wys vir owerhede en veldwagters waar daar 'n karkas is. Dit verhoog die stroopers se risiko om ontdek en gevang te word. Hulle glo dan dat dit hulle kan help om in hegtenisname en vervolging vry te spring as hulle aasvoëls doodmaak. Duisende aasvoëls is oor die afgelope paar jaar op hierdie manier doodgemaak.
So there's obviously a difference between deliberate poisoning and accidental poisoning. How does your approach differ between those two?
You know, the human wildlife conflict, vultures are very often not the intended victims of that poisoning. The easiest recourse for many people is to go and use pesticides, chemicals, place them out there, kill the target animal very often, but also as a result of that, those target animals and the carcasses that they sometimes lay kill hundreds, if not thousands, of vultures.
En dis nie al wat aasvoëls se oorlewing bedreig nie. Hulle word ook vir tradisionele gebruik geteken.
There's no medicinal value to vultures at all, as far as we know. In many areas, vultures have been extirpated for the trade in vulture body parts, which people believe if they use that, they acquire certain qualities.
Daar word geglo dat een van hierdie eienskappe intuïtiewe kennis is, soos die geloof dat om langs 'n aasvoël se kop te slaap geluk kan bring, of psigiese krag kan voorsien om byvoorbeeld die lotery of 'n sportwedstryd te wen. Op 'n onlangse navorsingsreis na die Kruger Wildtuin is 'n aasvoël wat onderste bo aan 'n boom opgehang is, onder andere se aandag gebring.
What we then found is on both legs there were, on the one side it was nylon rope and on the other one it was baling twine, that this bird was tied probably to a stake on the ground somewhere and was kept. Luckily there were people there that observed and we were able to extricate the bird. We kept it overnight, rehydrated it, gave it some fluids and then the next morning let it go and it took off and it flew well.
Hierdie voël het die dood vrygespring, maar duisende aasvoëls reg oor Afrika is nie so gelukkig nie. En hulle staar baie bedreigings in die gesig. Dus hoekom 'n veelsidige benadering nodig is om die spesies te help bewaar.
So it's clear that there's a whole host of threats facing the vultures across Africa. And when we have a look at the status of these birds, it really makes sober reading. The white-backed vulture, critically endangered. The bearded vulture, near threatened across the continent, but critically endangered here in South Africa. The Cape vulture, an endangered bird. The white-headed vulture, critically endangered. Leopard-faced vulture is endangered. And the hooded vulture is critically endangered across Africa. But the plight of vultures is not going unnoticed. There is a whole host of very, very talented individuals like Kerry, like Andre, working on this problem, as well as scientists from around the world. And as we learn more about them and we study them more closely, so solutions will be able to be found.
Andrei se veldwerk strek reg oor Afrika. Dit is die Gorongosa Wildtuin in Mosambiek, een van die plekke waar Andrei en sy span aasvoëls vang en van 'n halsband voorsien om hulle bewegings te monitor.
This is a GPS satellite transmitter.
By Valpro het Kerry 'n broeiprogram begin vir die voëls wat nie weer in die natuur vrygelaat kan word nie, met merkwaardige resultate.
There's a lot unusual going here. They've now got two chicks that are not even Cape vultures. How did this happen?
Okay, so this is really, really special. And this is the first time it's happened actually globally, as far as I'm aware. Firstly, this is a Cape vulture and the chicks are African white-backed vultures. The guys in the States with the Andean condor breeding programs have been using substitute parents for years. So the fact that this Cape vulture is a substitute parent for whitebacks, that is a known fact and it's been done previously. What makes this so unique is vultures only lay one egg per year. They only manage to raise one chick per year. We had two chicks, needed a mom. We didn't want to look at human imprinting. So we decided to give it a bash and to see if vultures can in fact raise two chicks without any assistance from us. And voila.
Yeah, I mean, so far they seem to be doing absolutely fine.
Yeah.
Is the behavior of an African white-backed chick any different to a Cape vulture chick at the same age?
Not at all. Cape vultures and African white-backed vultures are very, very similar in behavior, in adaptations and whatnot. So the only difference really is that obviously capes are much bigger and they breed on cliffs and white-backs breed on trees. But otherwise, behaviorally, very similar species. These guys will be fitted with tracking devices. If they behave like whitebacks, then this is huge for conservation and for breeding programs, because then we're able to give a pair
two chicks, for example, and maximize our breeding and to avoid any kind of human imprinting.
You can see there's very little glamorous about vulture conservation, you know, dragging carcasses around, and there is the smell of carrion in the air at a facility like this. They also have an incredibly strong digestive tract with a very, very acidic stomach, and that enables them to eat even very rotten meat that has been out in the hot sun for days and days and days without getting sick.
En dis net nog 'n rede om aasvoëls te bewaar, want hulle kan weerstand teen siektes soos miltsiekte en hondsdolheidpiek en keer dat dit versprei. As daar nie meer aasvoëls is om hierdie rol te vervul nie, kan siektes soos 'n veldbrand versprei en die ekonomiese koste hiervan is enorm.
And to give you a very pertinent and fairly extreme example, but the introduction of a single veterinary drug in South Asia led to a mass die-off of vultures, where vultures declined from more than 40 million birds in 7 years to less than 20,000 birds of three species in India and Pakistan. One agent that was introduced into a country and into an area that decimated vultures to that extent.
Hierdie anti-inflammatoriese middel staan as die Clovenac bekend. Dit is veronderstel om die gesondheid van vee te probeer verseker en nie om aasvoëls opsetlik skade aan te doen nie. Maar dit het, sonder aasvoëls en met baie kos beskikbaar, het die hoeveelheid rondloper honde geweldig toegeneem.
And these dogs are all over the place. They run around, they hunt. They obviously benefit from the carrion, but they also carry rabies and they attack people. What we've seen is that the Indian government really needs to spend billions of dollars annually to inoculate people, to treat people, and as we know, once rabies starts manifesting, there really isn't any effective treatment. So it's to try and prevent rabies in the population. So countries are starting to spend lots of money because vultures have disappeared from the environment.
Afrika-lande kan dit beslis nie bekostig om soveel geld op 'n gesondheidskwessie uit te gee, terwyl aasvoëls sou kon help om hierdie probleem op 'n natuurlike manier op te los nie. Aasvoëls in Afrika vlieg ook baie lang afstande, oor grense heen na verskillende lande toe, wat beteken dat as hulle sou verdwyn, die effek nie net op een plek gevoel sal word nie, maar oor 'n baie groter gebied.
These are six white-backed vultures, and you can see they were trapped there, and look at the area that they've covered. I mean, every single country in Southern Africa in 6 months by one of six birds. These birds live across Africa as such.
Vultures are unique among African endangered species in that they don't just stay within protected areas. They range very widely across national boundaries. And so the same bird that is at risk of collision here in South Africa could be targeted for belief use up in Zambia, could get poisoned in northern Mozambique.
It's critical that when we start looking at conservation, and these birds tell us that by what we learn from their movements, if we don't start looking at working across the entire population and approaching vulture conservation in Africa from an African perspective, a pan-African perspective, and start working together with other countries. You know, we can do, and we've done great work down here in South Africa over the last 50 years. We don't have a choice but to go out and to work with colleagues in these African countries to try and conserve these birds from an overall perspective, and to take hands and to work together, and to not want to sit in isolation and say, well, you know, we're going to conserve South African vultures. The truth is they are not South African vultures. Mm-hmm. They are African vultures. And unless we as Africans conserve these birds together, we are in, you know, we're going to fight a losing battle in the end.
Dit is 'n stryd wat ons dwars deur ons kontinent moet wen. As aasvoëls sou verdwyn, sal ons baie vinnig die gevolge voel. Hulle is 'n sluitsteen spesies en ons kan dit eenvoudig nie bekostig om hul waarde te onderskat nie.